Hello, Scuba here. Welcome back to Arcadia. I'm here back at the monument for two reasons. The first reason has been bugging me while I was editing, and that is when I accidentally broke this block, I also didn't place it back at the right location. So this should go there, and we should have one of those blocks there. That's better. It's been annoying me for a couple of days now. And the only place where I saw it actually was in the time lapse. I thought I was going crazy, but it was actually a misplaced block. The second reason we are here is because we are gonna extend this path over here. And we're gonna extend it all the way to the water here. And that is because if we follow this road over here, we actually end up at my new base location. Let's see if we can get a better look from here. We have the monument over here, and we're gonna be building the pathway to over here. Then we're gonna build a bridge, and then we got to do a whole lot of work here. First of which is to remove all the trees in this area over here. And that's a lot. What is pretty cool, by the way, is we can see so much stuff over here. We can see all of the shopping district. We can see the mapping building over there. We can see, I think it was Soonti who built this. And the campfire crew over there. I don't think we can actually see our starter base. Maybe if we fly over here. Let's see. Come on, render. Oh, I see one of the dragons. I think that's our starter base. Yes, we can see it from our new base location. And for our base, this whole island is gonna be ours. So we have this area over here and all the way around up to this river over here. And we have a pillager outpost. I'm not sure if that's gonna be handy, but we also have this mountain over here. But we're gonna start out with this area over here. Oh, I didn't see that yet. We actually have a mine shaft here, but looks like it's been raided and someone left a bed over here. Let's see, there's nothing here, right? No. Shall we steal the bed? I actually kind of need a bed. Yeah, I'm gonna yoink this. Sorry if anybody needs it, but I didn't have a second bed yet, so this is gonna be handy. Anyway, let's start by clearing out some of these trees here. This shouldn't take that long. Alright, that's much better. We now have a clear path towards the location of our bridge, which is gonna be right over here. And when I was clearing everything, I found this. I don't know if there's any bees in it, but we could use it. So, let's take that. Why is it still dripping? Okay, it's gone. That was weird. We want to clear out this a bit too. So let's do that quickly. Yeah, this will probably do. Alright, I'm gonna build this path and I will be right back with you. Alright, our pathway is done. So now we can actually connect to the shopping district with a bridge. Well, we're connecting to nothing because there's nothing yet, but there will be. And I will have access to the shopping district at walking distance. That's pretty cool. Alright, now that we have the road done, I guess it's time for a little time lapse. So let's cue the music and let's go. Alright, that didn't take that long. Our bridge is finished. And I must say it looks pretty good. But there's two things about this bridge that I'd like to address. The first of them is... what's this? That doesn't line up. Well, that's because I need to do a whole bunch of landscaping in our first area behind us here. But that's a job for later. The other thing I want to address are these poles here. They're quite useless right now. And that's why I want to visit Ender Threads. Ender Threads actually sells custom banners. So, let's see. Are you interested in a custom banner design? If so, read through this book for more info. For 2 diamonds, that's not much. A banner design along with 2 banners all crafted for your use. Okay, message Tooth to begin the designing process. Payments will be taken upon completed and approved designs. Alright, yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to contact Tooth for a custom banner design. But anyway, we're gonna need one. I'm gonna ask him to design a banner fit for a kingdom. So let's see what he comes up with. The next thing we need to do is clear out all these trees over here. But before we can do that, yeah, this axe is not gonna do it. It doesn't have any enchants. We're gonna have to get an upgrade. And while I'm at it, I might as well upgrade my shovel, because we also need to do a whole bunch of landscaping. Anyway, let's take a look in Triss's bookshop here. Books go down. Let's break out our wallet. Everything, 1 diamond. Okay, let's see. First of all, we need efficiency. We want to have unbreaking. We want to have mending. I guess we want 2 efficiency. Okay, for our axe, we actually want silk touch. Oh, wait, I'm completely lost now. Here we go, silk touch. So 1 silk touch. Let's get some sharpness too. So then for our axe, we have unbreaking, mending, efficiency, silk touch, and sharpness. And for our shovel, we have unbreaking and mending, efficiency, and let's get silk touch for that too. There we go. And that's actually a perfect 9 diamonds. So let's craft it into a block and let's leave our payment. There we go. And now I have another problem. I don't have any experience and I don't have an experience farm. So how am I gonna do this? I guess I'm gonna contact someone to check if I can use one of their farms. So I'll do that and I will be back with you later. I just heard that I can use Kaimadar's gold farm to get some experience. And that should be on the nether roof somewhere over here. And I think I see it already. Let's see. Okay, it's one of those. And shoot a piglin close to you. And just wait for XP. Oh, alright. One problem. I don't have a bow. Let's go! Stand here. Collect experience. Let's go! Yeah, these are the anvils I can actually use. This is already so quick. There we go, we have our shovel. That's 26, let's go. Now let's repair them. And let's actually rename them. So we have Scuba's Tree Feather, Scuba's Dirt Shoveler, and we actually still have a sword to rename. So let's rename that to Scuba Street Sweeper. There we go. We're all set. Let's get out of here. Thank you, Kaimadar, for letting me use your farm, by the way. That's awesome. And I guess now it's time to remove all of those trees over there. So let's start another time lapse. And let's get chopping. Let's go. Alright, we cut down almost all of the trees here. Anyway, we have a whole bunch of wood now. 2 shulker boxes of wood. And a whole bunch of leaves and sticks and some dirt. And while I was doing the last part here, I got a visit from Cornmilk. And later, Soonti joined too.
Hello! I could see all the entities on minimap. You have been making a mess around here. I'm just gonna pick everything up.
Oh, ow! There's a hole.
Never would have guessed.
Oh no. Are you freaking planting? No, 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 no. Please, no. No, no. 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 Stop it. I am gonna have to clear this twice.
Well, only if you're sloppy and don't pick up your trees. You see, this is just an incentive for you to pick up your trees.
Yeah, but I have so many saplings.
The sapling in the ground is worth two in the hand.
Oh,
so wait a minute.
Hey, let me sleep.
Hey, no.
Let me sleep.
No.
Okay. Not gonna sleep then.
Yeah, no sleep, no sleep.
No sleep. More
no
danger.
Sleep. More danger. I mean, look at this mess you've made. No,
I didn't make
no,
a mess.
No, 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 where are you? No, no, no.
Ah! No, my bed. Come on.
No sleep for you.
I slept already. Ah.
No sleep for you tomorrow night. I've been looking for something to do. And I found it. It's annoying people.
I can understand.
I feel like
that.
I should make a service out of it.
I respect that.
You know?
Yeah, yeah.
I feel like
annoyance,
I should make a service out of it. Like surface. You can pick you sort of like you can pay me to go annoy someone else, you know? Yes!
I see the saplings. What happened?
One of them grew!
After this, we hung out a bit more. Many saplings were planted and many were removed. And since this is corn, a lot of murder happened too. After a while, Soonti joined us and we decided to go to the questing tavern. The questing guild.
Ta-da! You were in season one, right?
Yeah, I was.
What was your base?
It started out with only like a tent in the jungle, far away from everybody, and then I moved like halfway throughout the season. Why?
Well, it's just one of the questions.
Okay, so I think I need to explain something here. This behind me is the questing tavern. In our last episode, this was the building that I didn't check out yet, because I knew there was way more to it than only checking out what they sell. Because this is not a shop. And by the way, it looks beautiful. All the way in the top here, we have the questing guild. And there's a book here, so let's read it. Welcome to the Arcadian Questing Guild. The questing guild is a group of adventurers that complete requested quests from local townsfolk. Some quests can be simple, while others may have you dive deep into unexplored areas or fight off monsters. We are a fairly new guild here and are looking for new members. If this is something you wish to be a part of, you will need to test your skills first. I've created a bit of a scavenger hunt for the server to observe your abilities. Upon completion, you will not only receive monetary value, but you will be accepted into the questing guild as an official member. Good luck. So, I actually took a book from here. That should be in my inventory right here. Let's see. Nope, that's cow jokes. There we go. So, this is the quest book. And there's a bunch of questions here that we need to answer, like find three Arcadians from the same country, or find an Arcadian that likes building with diorite. And that's why we stuck around for a bit and we started asking each other questions. Now let's actually go see that. Your favorite color is green, right?
Yeah!
Building with diorite? Okay. I built with diorite before.
Do you like it though?
It depends. I'm not against it.
Then we can't use you for that.
Corn, do you define yourself more as a redstoner, a builder, or a terraformer? And what about your scuba?
I don't think I'm any of those things.
Redstoner.
Redstoner? Okay.
I just like exploring and telling stories.
Okay, what's the next question?
I have to find a Arcadian with a full netherite armor, and I guess that's you.
And I guess it's you then.
Full netherite armor.
Scuba, I heard you like potatoes.
He does!
I just read that question. Yeah. It is actually my favorite food in Minecraft. It's easy to get.
Sorry.
And it's so much better than carrots.
No, it's not. Be quiet. Corin, did you ever pull
pranks
on somebody?
No, I just like murder.
Do you guys pray to Lord Salmonella?
No.
I don't believe in God, but
Zunti
does.
No. I pray to Solomon, but not Salmonella.
Salmonella, okay.
Yeah.
Do you guys play modded or not?
I sometimes play modded Minecraft, yeah.
I've never played modded. This is the most modded I've played.
Yeah, so what do you guys prefer, Other Side or Pikmin?
Other Side all the way. And you, Scuba?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I think Other Side too. Yeah, yeah.
What about you, Zunti?
Pixstep.
I think we're kind of cheating, Essence.
Oh, wait.
I think we're supposed to talk to more people than each other.
And that's exactly what we did. We decided to visit Mr. Gadlord. That way, we might be able to finish some more quests. Hey!
Hey, it's good.
Okay. Did you ever pull a prank on other Arcadians?
Yes.
Okay, what?
Oh, thanks for the tree, by the way.
Yeah, you're welcome, buddy. Yeah, I gave Scuba a tree made from crafting tables. I changed your farm into kelp.
Oh, yeah.
I put a bunch of chickens in Humble's base, and I don't think you've been back to see it yet.
Scuba, come here.
What's up?
Me cooked salmon.
Cooked salmon?
Cooked salmon! I sat on his egg.
He actually asked the correct colors for it. Wait. Gadlord, I'm gonna trust you with taking care of something for me.
Hang on, Scuba, I can't quite hear you. I'm coming.
I'm gonna trust you with taking care of this.
Oh, okay. Very good.
I don't really have a place to hash him.
Here's an empty name tag for when he hatches. You can give him a name. That way we'll know.
Awesome.
I personally suggest cooked mutton chop, but...
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah. Do you play modded Minecraft?
Well, technically we're playing modded right now.
Oh, yeah, Yeah. But I don't think that counts. Hello?
I made a nest.
Oh, I see.
Oh, he's cracking! Oh my gosh!
Oh!
Hello, baby!
Almost there.
Cooked mutton. You got this, cooked mutton. Would you like to sit on the egg?
Oh, yeah.
We need to keep it warm until it hatches.
Of course.
Otherwise, it won't hatch right. You're gonna be such a good little sniffer. You're gonna be the cutest, and your ears are gonna go flop, 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 flop.
He's gonna be the best.
Here you go.
The best sniffer ever.
And you're gonna smell so many things. Your nose is gonna be disproportionately large for your body. It's gonna be wonderful.
Hey, don't make fun of his nose.
No, I just said it's wonderful.
He hasn't even born yet. Oh, okay.
I just said it's wonderful.
Then it's all right. Then it's all right. He's taking a while.
Let him take his time. Hatching is a complicated process.
Wait, we can do another question. Gadlord, do you have a clock?
I have a clock. Let's see. I might. Would it be cheating if I went and made one?
Yes, it will. Yeah, it actually
it's explicitly
says.
In the instructions
so,
of cheating.
Yeah.
All right.
And.
Oh, he's wait,
what?
More. He cracked more!
Cracking. So, it actually says. And that didn't make one just now because you asked them to.
Okay. Like the first question was finding an Arcadian who has a base in season one?
Yeah.
So technically. Technically, I did have a base in season one. It was underneath Triss's base. I just never made any videos.
Wait, what?
Yeah. I got on the season one world, and I made a base underneath Triss's base. So technically, I have a base in season one.
But you can't use yourself. That's one of the rules.
Yeah, I know.
But I can.
It's very much a technicality, so I don't know if that actually counts. But.
Deliver a dozen chocolate chip cookies to a fellow Arcadian. Okay, that's why there's... 12 cookies in a barrel in front of my house.
Oh.
Pull a prank on someone. Okay.
Wait, there's one to pull a prank on someone?
Yeah.
Does a putting a sniffer egg in my base without telling me count as a prank? Or
that's not a prank.
Wait, who did that? Who did that?
There's a scuba just now.
No, he told you. He told you.
He told me.
Oh, let's go. Hello, cooked mutton.
Wait, have you ever fed a baby sniffer before? Cat, get seeds!
There we go.
Feed him.
Mutton.
Give him little snickies. Yeah.
Oh, I got an achievement.
Yeah, for feeding babies.
Feed a snifflet.
Yeah. Hello. You want to go back in your nest? You want to go on top of your nest?
Of course.
Very smart.
He's a little rebel. So, Cat, I don't really have a place for... our little cooked mutton here. So it's okay if I leave him here with you, right?
Yeah, I know. There should be enough space for it.
Oh, okay.
Oh my gosh,
nice.
Scuba, are you about to be a deadbeat dad?
Yeah.
I'm going to come around to your base once a month for child support.
Yeah.
Child support payment.
I will get him at some point, but like...
Oh, okay.
I actually need to get the base first. I'm tired. I'm gonna go too. It was awesome hanging out, Gadlord, and thank you for being a better parent than me and taking care of little
you know, it's
mutton.
Not too late to be a good. It's not too late to be a good parent, Scuba.
Yeah, but
just
I'm too young to have children.
You know? Aren't you older than both Kat and I?
Probably, yeah.
I thought you were like 40 or something.
No, not that old. No.
Oh.
I'm 35, so I'm getting there.
Yeah, so
I'm
you're 40. There.
No! Okay, bye, Kat. One more thing to do here. Not sure what to do with this space. Taking suggestions. Well. And there we go. Put a prank on someone. Who was pranked? Gwen. I think that counts. And let's make a delivery. Oh, that's the tree, by the way. And here's the cookies. Cookie delivery. Thank you, random person with the cookie delivery. That's awesome. Cookies. Totally not for the quest. There we go. Got another one. Deliver a dozen chocolate chip cookies. I didn't make the cookies, but I delivered them. Yeah, I think that counts. Alright, this episode is already 20 minutes long, so I think this is gonna do for this episode. We actually got a lot done here, and I am excited to get terraforming soon. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye!